So hello guys, so today we will discuss about web technology lab assignment number 1B. So in this assignment you have to design a suitable web application using HTML, CSS and XML. So we will discuss about some steps here first. So first of all, you have to open any text editor. So I'm using brackets editor here, text editor. Then you have to design the registration and login form in HTML by applying a proper CSS. Okay. Then you have to create an XML accessibility file and link with the HTML login form. And finally, you have to run the HTML files in web browser. So here, these parameters I am considering for my student registration form. So now, see how I'm going to design my registration form. So this is my rough design. You can see I have drawn one table here. So in this table I have created two columns. In left column I have put my all the parameters. In right column I will be having my all the fields, like username is having a text field, so that field will be here. Okay, so here what I'm doing, I'm using the 100% width of my page. So out of that I'm using 20% width for the labels. These are the labels, and 80% width for my all the fields here. Okay, so this type of arrangement or this type of model is called the box model. Why? Because here I'm putting everything inside the box. You can see that this username, this password, all these are put inside this rectangle. So this rectangle is nothing but a box. So same thing that here, that is all the fields that we are going to put inside this rectangle, that is inside this box. So this box model we have to follow while writing the HTML code, because that will easy to apply, that will make us easy for while applying the CSS. So now we'll go for writing the code. So I'll go inside in the brackets editor. Here I have already created the register.html file, where I already created the structure, HTML document structure. So you know that doc type HTML is specifying the HTML document type. Then inside HTML tag, I have written head tag, which is describing the invisible part. Then inside this, I have defined the title tag. So in this title tag, show the web page title. And then now come to the body tag. Inside body tag, we will define the visible part. Now, first of all, we'll do one thing, that is we'll write one heading. So I'll write heading registration form. So after that I'll put one horizontal line, and after that I told you that we have to follow box model. So here we can follow, or you can use the box model with the help of division tag. So I'll create a box with the help of div tag. So this is my one of the box. So inside this box I will go for form tag. Okay, so after that, in form tag, right now I will use action is equal to blank, because I don't want to redirect page now, and I will use method equal to anything you can use, or you can leave it blank. Okay, so inside this form tag I will go for my again the different boxes where I want to put my label and my fields. So I'll create one box again. So inside this box, you can say I'll create one box again, and inside this box again I will create two boxes. So inside this first box I'll write my label. So with the help of label tag, I'll write here username. Okay, so this is my username here. So in the second div tag, I'll write my input type. So input tag. So input type equal to I'm using here text. Then after that, I'm going to use the placeholder. So here I'll write enter your username. So this I'm going to use here. After that, I'm going to use other div tag. So inside this div tag, I'm going to use again the same thing, that two div tags, because see here I'm doing what, I'm creating the first container, that is container box. Inside this I'm putting a form, and inside this form I'm again creating the tag, I'm creating the boxes. So a big box I'm creating first, so this is my first one box, and inside this I'm having a two boxes again, you know, that is label and my text field here. Okay, so same way I have created second box with the help of div tag, and after that inside this box I'm putting my label. So you know that the second label is password. So after this I'm putting my input type equal to password. Okay, so here I'm again using placeholder. So placeholder, use enter your password. Okay, so now after this, the same thing we have to do. So I will copy the code and paste it here. Okay, so the third level is my confirm password. So confirm password. Okay, so remaining thing I will put it as it is. The same thing I want to do for next. Okay, so next I'm having which field, see which field I'm having. So next I'm having a post name, last name. So I'll create the same thing I want to do here. So I'll remove this password. So I'll write post name, and here instead of password type I'll write text. Okay, and then with the help of instead of this enter your password, I'll write enter your first name. So after this, the same thing I will copy and paste. And now I will do here, I will replace with this first with last. Okay, then I'll replace with this first name with last name. Okay, so after this I'm having a gender. Okay, so for gender I'll again copy and paste this code, but this time I will replace with this label with gender. And now here inside this one of the div tag is this div tag. I'll put this, okay, I will use input tag here, but in input I will specify the type, that is radio, because it is a radio button. I'm going to use radio button. So this I will remove here, and I'll write name equal to gender. Okay, and here I'll write this male. Okay, and after that I'll copy the same thing here, because I want to do same thing here. So copy the same thing, paste it here, and I'll replace with this male with female. Okay, so gender. So this way I'll define the gender. Okay, now after that we know that the next field is what we are having, an email, course and mobile number. So we'll define that field also. So I'll again copy this code, because not necessary to write again it. So I'll just copy and paste. So here I will replace with email. Okay, so we know that in HTML5 it has come with the different of input types. So for email there is also email type, so that it does the validation itself. Okay, automatically. So here I will write enter your email address. Okay, so enter your email ID. All right, so after this we're having the next row in which we are having again course. Okay, so I'll use course. So see here, for course I will use the select. Okay, I'll use the select box. So how to define select box, I'll tell you here. So just use select tag. Okay, so inside this select tag, use option tag. Okay, within pop option tag, define your option. So I'll use select class first option. The same thing I will copy here. I'll copy it. I'll go. Okay, so next option I will write here, that is SE comp. The next option I will write here, that is EBROM. Okay. So third option I will write here, that is VCOMP. Okay, so this way I have written the select tag, okay, for creating the select box here. Now after this, the next thing is that contact number, okay, mobile number. So I will copy again this code for email ID, because we are not going to do write anything new there. Write it here. I will just replace with email with mobile number. Okay, this email with, I will replace with the text, and this placeholder here I will replace with the enter your mobile number. Okay, so this we have completed here. Okay, now after mobile number we have to define the we define our submit button and reset button. So here we go for this type. In this div tag, I will go for type equal to submit. Okay, and then value equal to submit. So I want there a submit button, and I want a reset button. So I will write type equal to reset as with the reset button. So value equal to reset. Okay, so here our form has been completed. Okay, so this we have done with the help of HTML only. Now we'll run this code, we'll see the output. Okay, so now you can see this is registration form has been displayed here. So username, enter your username, password, you have enter your password. Okay, it's confirm password, enter your password. So first name, last name, gender, then email, then course. In course I have put all these options. Okay, so then enter your mobile number and submit button. Okay, so in submit button, then reset button. Okay, so this is the output of your registration form. Then now we'll apply the CSS on this form. Okay, now the form is created here, so we'll apply the CSS. So I'll create again a new file, but before that I will explain this. Okay, so here I'll create a new file and I will save it with the name of style.css. okay, so here in this CSS file, how to write CSS, that I want to tell you. That is, see here, the code starts from this div tag. Okay, so whenever you are going from, or your code start or visible part starts from this body tag. So whenever you are writing your CSS, go from top to bottom. This first target the big element, and then or root element, and then go inside the child element. So we'll start from the body tag, means the root element. So the I will use here asterisk for selecting all the elements. So you know that in the CSS, outright CSS, this is selector. So this is universal selector. So it is selecting all the elements. So I'm using inertial selector. So inside this inertial selector, how to write it? So this is selector. This is declaration block where I'm using these curly brackets. Inside this declaration block, I'm declaring my CSS property and values, CSS properties. So here I want to use box sizing. Okay, so this property I want to use, and this property I will use border dash box. Okay, value. So later on I will explain what is this box sizing and why to use a box sizing and border dash box here. Okay, so here I have defined this property box dash sizing for all the elements. Now the next the big element or the root element is my this div. Okay, so for that div I will use a class selector. So I'll write dot container. You know that how to use a class selector in CSS. So you can use a dot operator, the dot, and then after that you give the name. You should give the name to that class. Okay, so this whole thing is called as a class selector. So inside this class selector, I'll use the style that is background dash color. So I'll give the background color here. So just for I'll use here aquamarine. Okay, so this color, or you can use if you know the color names, you can use directly the color names, or otherwise you can use the hex code also. Yeah, that you can find out internet also, that hex code and RGB values. After that I'm using one. Okay, I want to use a border here. Okay, so use border. So I'll give the size of my border, that is 1px, then the style of my border, that is solid, and the color I will use here, that is red. Okay, after that I want a rounded border. So I'll use the border dash radius property, CSS property, that you can use for applying the rounded borders in your CSS or in your HTML page or web page. So here I'll use a 5px radius, so it will apply on four corners and it will make my borders rounded corner. Okay, so for this I'll use this. Okay, so if you see the output now, okay, you cannot see the output, or this style will not be applied on your this HTML file. So for applying this style on your this form, you have to first link this CSS file with your HTML file. So you can use a link tag. So here in link tag you can use a relation, that is style sheet. What is the relation? That is style sheet is the relationship with this file, and then href is equal to this style dot CSS. Okay, so after this, to apply this file, okay, this is a class selector that I want to apply on this first, that is my parent box, that is this div tag. So I'll use your class attribute, and inside this I'll write this container. Okay, now if you see the output, let me see the output. Now you can see what you can see, that is the color aquamarine has been applied on my this box. So this box has been created. Inside this box all these elements have been put here. So this way you can understand. Okay, so you can understand that how I have applied the style here. Okay, so now come back to the code. Now you have to apply the style on other elements here. So now see, if I want to apply, I'm having the different input types here. So just see, I'm having input types like okay, so text, I'm having a text, password, and everything else. Okay, so but before that, I told you that in this rough design, I told you that this I'm going to store in put in inside the 20% width, and this remaining fields I'm going to put inside the 80% width. So now we'll define the style for this thing. So I'll write, I will again use class selector. Okay, so I'll write a class selector here. So I'll write call dash 20, as we are going to use 20% width. So I'm giving the name call dash 20 because the class name should be, or the selector name should be relevant to your style. Okay, so call dash 20. So you gotta write width. Okay, so width is equal to 20%. Okay, then I'll write float. I want to float this element in left side. I'll write float left. Then I want to set a margin. Okay, so I'll set a margin top. Okay, so I'll set something 5 pixel. Okay, so this is my call dash 20. So for next, that is for 80% width, again I will define this same, that is call dash 80, and I'll replace this width with 80% value. Okay, so remaining thing will be same here. Okay, so now if I want to use this style on my these elements, so I'll do one thing here. I'll go on my, again on this div tag. So now see, this tab div tag is remaining there. So that div tag is showing, is representing the particular row there. Okay, so this particular row, this whole row which is having a username column and this text field column, so that are inside this box. That whole row is represented by this div tag. So here I will directly write the class attribute, and I will give the name class selector, that is row here. So for that purpose here, before this I'll define dot row. Okay, row class selector, inside this I'll write, okay, so inside this, okay, so here I will use a solo selector, that is after. Okay, so what I want to do, that is after this row, what I want to do, that I will define here. So write content. Okay, so content will be blank here. Okay, then I want to display it in a table form, so that I have to use your display property. And then see, I want to clear. Okay, so I'll clear both sides. So I don't want to float either on left side or right side. So I will use here a clear property, so that will clear the both floating values. Okay, so this you have to do here. So it will write the content, blank content, then it will display in table form that row, and it will clear both the sides. It does not allow the left and right floating. Okay, so if I use these styles here, see, I have used row class selector here. Now the next, inside that I am having two columns. So for first column I will use a call dash 20 class selector, because my first column is of 20% width, and for second column, okay, so here you can see for the second column, this is the second column which is having a input text field. So there again I will use a class equal to call dash 80. Okay, so if you implement, okay, now we'll see the output of this. Okay, so now you can see my output has been displayed in this form, that is in left side the username is displayed, and right side my text field has been displayed. But now see, you can see that this text field is having only this much of width. Okay, but if I want to increase its width, what I will do, I'll add one property in my CSS here. So I'll do one thing here. Okay, so I'll do one thing here, that is I'll directly define a style for all the types, like the input type, that is text. Okay, then I'm having input type password, Okay, then I'm having the input type email. Okay, then I'm having other input type. Okay, I think I'm having a password, text, password, and email. Only these input types I'm having. So all these, for these, all these input types, I will do one thing, that is I will set the width 100%. Okay, then after that I will set a padding, something that, you know, that inner space I will show, I will leave some space here, inside space, that is called the padding. So I'll add, let's consider I will add a 5 pixel padding here. So see now what changes will happen in this form. Oh, you can see, this form has been displayed in this way. Okay, that is username is displayed here and your text field is displayed again. See here, this thing is very close to the border and this thing is also very close to the border. So if I want to separate it again, we have to apply a border here. Sorry, again we have to use here something padding. So where will you use padding? So inside this container, okay, this is your main box. Inside this padding I will use a near about 10 pixel. Okay, so use a 10 pixel padding. Now you can see, now it is properly visible. Now you can see. Okay, now now I will clear you about the box sizing, border dash box, that box sizing property. Now see, if you don't use border dash box property, let me show you the output. That is, if I don't use, let me show you. Just okay, if I don't use border dash box property, now see what is happening here. My these input fields are going outside this box. Okay, why? Because here it is not considering, it is not merging the padding border and the width of this. Okay, so here it is doing what? It is considering this width of this element as a separate width, the width of this box as a separate width. It's a border width, separate size. Okay, so every values are considered differently here. So because of that, this box is going outside this box. Okay, so to make it inside this box, we are using a border dash box sizing property, which is adjusting the width, or which is adjusting the padding and border inside the width of, okay, in the width of this input field. Okay, this box. So because of that, here the box sizing property is used. Okay, so box sizing property is having a border dash box, so it will make the it will merge the padding and all the things inside of width. Okay, so that will be calculated in that way. Okay, so this way you can see your form is now looking good. Okay, now see, I want to do what now? Okay, now I'll add the same thing in the same property. Okay, so same properties I will add, same class selectors I'll add in other parameters. So here I will add class equal to row, because inside this row I'm having a two columns. So my first column is having first column class equal to, okay, all dash 20. Okay, so my second is having class equal to all dash 80. So I'll just simply copy and paste it. Okay, same thing I will repeat for other fields here. Okay, so here I will put class is equal to row. Okay, then here class equal to call dash ed. Here dash 20 same here, class equal to row. Okay, so here I'll put call dash 18. This style I'll apply here. So again for last name I'll use the same thing here, that is call dash 20 here. Here class equal to row. Now you can observe the output now, that is how this design is going on there. So this is the last name, then for gender, okay, for gender so I'm using the same thing here again, class equal to row. Okay, after this, in this again I will put here 18. Okay, then after this again for this I put class equal to row, and here class equal to call dash 20. Again here I put call dash 80 for email address, and for mobile codes also I use here class row. Here I will use call dash 20. Here the same in the second box I'd use call dash 80. Okay, and now here I'll go for, okay, so here I'll use class row, then here call dash 20, here I'll use call dash 80. Okay, finally for this submit and reset button I'll just use row here. Okay, now you can observe the output here. You can observe the output. Now my form is looking good. Okay, you can see that in left side my all the labels are seen. Okay, they are visible, they are arranged properly, and in right side my all the text fields have been arranged. Okay, so you can apply other styles, so like you can apply border property here again, border dash radius property to make this fields again good or impressive. So that thing you can do. Okay, so this is just a simple example of a registration form that you have to do in your assignment number 1. So after this, you with the help of this or with the reference of this, you can create your login form. Okay, so let me just explain you the login form now. So now we have created the registration form, now we'll design the login form now. Okay, so we'll do one thing here. Okay, so we'll close this. Okay, create log new file, save it, login.html. okay, so here I'll write doc type HTML. Inside this HTML we'll write head. Inside head I'll write title. So login form. Inside this, after that I'll write body tag. So inside this body tag now I'll write again h1. So login form, this I will write here, and then I'll draw the horizontal line with the help of HR tag. Now here again I will do one thing, I will create a box with the help of div tag, div tag, division tag, and inside that I'll put my form tag. Okay, so inside this form tag I will do one thing again, that is I'll create a div tag, division tag, inside that division tag I'll create my this two division tags. Now you know that how to use it. Okay, so inside this first division will have the label that is username. Okay, and the second div tag will have the input, that is input type is equal to text. In the plus folder, it shows the hint for the user to understand what value he has to enter there. So enter your username. So this is my first row. Okay, so this is my first row. In that first row, I have defined username one of the column, and their text field is another column. Okay, so in second div tag, that will be my second row. In that second row, again I will create two boxes with the help of div tag, and here I'll again go for label. So in this label, I'll write password. Okay, and then in second here I'll write input type is equal to password, then place folder. So I'll write placeholder, enter your password. Okay, and outside this I'll write a div tag. Inside this div tag, I'll write just simply I will write input type. I'll create a button, so submit. Okay, then value equal to login. Okay, and then second button will be input type equal to submit. Sorry, reset, and its value will be reset. Okay, now you can see the output of this form. Close this form. Now I'll open this form. Now you can see this is my login form. Now you can apply this style on this. The same approach you have to use that I have used in registration form, the same approach you can use in login form to apply this style. Okay, so the remaining portion of this assignment, that is the use of XML and XSLT, so that I will record that portion I will record in a new video. So thank you for watching my video. If you have any comment, any doubt, you just post me in the comment box, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Okay, so thank you. Bye bye. Good night.